Thank you for watching, everybody. If you can watch to the end, I'm going to show you something really interesting about home security, basically for your front door, okay? I think a lot of people are worried about burglars or something else happening. It's really easy for a burglar to get into your house, by the way, through your front door. They don't have to even be loud. But that's not why I'm talking to you right now. I have an important message that you probably haven't heard or you haven't listened to. And it's actually very interesting. And it is in the King James Bible. I have, you know, regular 120 running in this cabin, but I also have DC power from car batteries. And so the light that you're seeing me in is 12 volt light, and to me it's a lot calmer. It's John chapter 3, verse 1, and I'll read, I might skip through it a little bit. There was a man of the Pharisees, who were the Jewish elite, named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. Let me stop you right there. If they knew he was a teacher come by God, why do they have so much fear of the people? It was the times they were living in, sort of like today, okay? For no man can do these miracles that thou doest, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. I'm not talking in silly parables here. How are you born again? And Nicodemus was thinking kind of like this. He took him on his word, which is a good thing. Nicodemus saith unto him, How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except the man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. So there's a difference. Christians have a body still while they're living. But then they have the spirit, so they're a different creature. Once you've accepted it, you feel it, and it's not a scary or bad thing. You might be scared of something new, but when you die, which will happen someday, you're going to say, why didn't I just do that? It's kind of like if your house ever had been on fire, you say, why didn't I just buy a little fire extinguisher? You can get a really little cheap one for like, what, $10, $20? A really good one for $100, a big one? Come on, come on. It's your soul. Marvel not that I said unto thee, ye must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but canst not tell whence it cometh. Whence it cometh. Okay, this is the Old Testament. So that's like where it comes from. That's my understanding of it. And whither it goeth, where it goes. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. And boy, is that true. He might give you visions and dreams and the gift of the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost. but you don't. For one instance, you don't know when he's coming. You only know when he's near. A lot of us Christians feel like the coming of Jesus is very near. Who knows, tomorrow, 5 minutes from now, 100 years from now, you could die before that happens and you're still going to see Jesus. That doesn't mean that it's going to be in a good way. You know, it's like, I'm going to try to remember to show you what I've done for security for my entry door. It's like, knock, knock, knock. How often do you answer the front door to someone you don't know? And you're a human being who has lower standards than God, so sometimes you do. Okay? A lot of people don't know what baptism is. But I'm going to skip around and read from Mark. Be patient. Not all of this video is going to be reading from the Bible. If you don't like that kind of thing. I didn't like that kind of thing when I was younger and I began to like it. A lot. Sometimes you grow up. Okay? Sometimes if you're 100 years old, 70 years old, you still got some growing up to do. Don't be offended by that. All of us come short. This is the Gospel according to Mark from the King James Bible. Chapter 1, verse 5. And there went out unto him all the land of Judea, and they of Jerusalem, and were all baptized of him in the river of Jordan, and confessing their sins. And John was clothed with camel's hair and with a girdle of skin about his loins, and he did eat locusts and wild honey. Interesting food. You can eat locusts, by the way. It is an insect, but hey, I've tried them. They're not too bad. I'm just saying. And verse 7, and preached, saying, there cometh one mightier than I after me, the latchet of whose shoes I am not worthy to stoop down and unloose. He's a son of God. There is forms of proof on the internet that aren't. I know how non-Christians think. Okay. Let's watch that because that makes sense. Yeah, but there are. One man actually found the real Ark of the Covenant, and it actually looks like how the Bible describes. You'll see pictures of the Ark of the Covenant. That doesn't make any sense because the angels are on the table. But they're actually at the ends of the table if you read the Bible. And the guy describes what he saw, and that's how he saw it. They took a DNA test of what looked like blood and water on the Ark of the Covenant. The real Ark of the Covenant that they say they can't find. It happened, according to what I've seen on this report, which I do believe, it was under, maybe not directly or maybe directly under, I don't know, but under where Jesus was crucified on the hill of Golgotha, which is the skull of the hill, which when you look at the side of the hill, it looks kind of like a skull, two circles. And they tested the stuff on the table and found human DNA. And the father's side of the DNA was not like human DNA. What does that tell you? You know, know, you can keep fighting it all you want. Jesus is the Son of God. He had the only DNA that comes straight from God. If you read this and you understand what that means, because Mary, his mother, did not have any relations with any man before Jesus was born, and yet was pregnant with the Son of God. And Jesus was baptized of John the Baptist, even though John confessed that, you know, Jesus was better. Why are you baptizing me? I need to be baptized of you, Jesus. It doesn't have to be the River Jordan. You can always go to Israel and be baptized of a true Christian who believes in the River Jordan or in the river, or like a lot of us, in a church, in a Pentecostal church or non-denominational church, in water, you're immersed, you have clothes on, you're all wet. Sometimes, don't be afraid of new things. Don't be afraid of things of the Spirit. You could come out of that water speaking in tongues. You could be coming out of the water just screaming, Hallelujah! Even though you're still alive physically, you've died. What a wonderful way to die. Isn't that better than getting hit by a car, dying for 20 years of cancer, dying of diabetes, obesity, heart attack, which is the most common? So basically you're talking to a dead man. Okay? Anyone who's a Christian has died. In fact, a week after I had been invited to church, I was in a horrible, horrible accident, in a wreck. And I was paralyzed, and if I had been left there without medical intervention, I would have just stopped being able to breathe on my own and suffocated due to lack of oxygen or whatever. You know, I couldn't get up and help myself. And it was hard to breathe because the accident damaged my level from here down, which controls your breathing. So I was only breathing through what you would call like peripheral, what do you call that? Your peripheral nervous system. So I couldn't scream, I could talk quietly. Help me. There are people all around though. Anyway, that's not what I'm saying. You could die at any moment. Oh, I'm in good health, or I'm in bad health, and the doctor says I have 5 more years. You don't know what's going to happen, but boom, don't wake up. Okay, where are you going to go? How do you accept Jesus? Pray. Not in the open, but in private, like the Bible says, in the closet. This is a very small cabin right now. It's the cabin. I plan on building onto it, bathroom, garage, upstairs. So I don't need to say that no one's watching me if I pray. The next step, someone invites you to church, say, I'd like to be baptized in the name of Jesus. For real. If they do something strange, like say, oh, you just have to accept it and that's it. Okay, come on, man. I want to be baptized, water baptized, underwater. Go to a Pentecostal church or a non-denominational church and be baptized, because that's how it's done. And there's more to it after that, but that's the first step. I admit, anybody can be afraid. It's like, hey, this is going to change my life, and isn't it insane to believe in something that you can't see? Well, when you do believe, you can see for a change. There's so much more to it than that. I'm going to leave it short. Boy, is it hot today, okay? I tell you, you can suffer a lot. It's like nighttime and it's still hot. When you're suffering, I don't care if it's because of the temperature, or because you're hungry, or because the world just plain sucks right now. Yeah, it probably always has, okay? If it's getting worse, don't be upset about it. But I think you should prepare first with being baptized in the name of Jesus, repenting of your sins. You probably should look up what repent means. If you used to be a murderer and you've murdered people, I don't care if you were in some war and you've killed people, then you have to be a lifesaver. You should be a lifesaver, save a life somehow. But also you should prepare for the times that are coming, because who's going to feed you, right? You have responsibilities to your family and to other Christians. Now I thought if I had remembered to, I would show you what we got going on for security here for our front door. 1, 2, 3. Why is it so dark? 4 hinges. 1 point of engagement up here, followed by the latch, which I will show you, and the floor latch. Okay. When I lock this door, ain't no one coming in here unless they've got about 30-40 minutes to break it down somehow. Okay, someone comes. Who is it? Your friend? Okay, I'll open it. If your door is over 3 inches thick and you have wood going one direction, the other direction, and then the other direction again, like this, and it's all screwed together with lots of screws, that's a very strong door. But if you just put a deadbolt in it, those things break really easily. Okay, I'm going to close it. Nice solid sound. Let's say I don't know the person. Yeah. You might want to slow that down and look at that again. There's a lock. It's connected to the key. From the outside, I can use the key. Okay? This is sort of an analogy, too. It's locked from below, the middle, and the top. Okay. Who is it? No answer. I also have a little sight hole. All I can see is my truck and dwindling twilight. You know, what I would say is, I don't know who you are. I don't see nobody. Please leave. I'm sorry, but please leave. You know what God would say, or at least in the Bible, Jesus would say, depart from me, I never knew you. Do not let that happen to you. Your soul is worth saving. Be a lot of family to see in heaven. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you. Please like, subscribe, and share, so I can get more than 21 subscribers. Okay? Thank you so much. Goodbye. God bless you. And listen to the times that we're in.